Hello and welcome to another edition of The Wedding Experts, filled with all the information you could possibly need for your big day. You could say this episode was jam-packed, because it's all about cakes. I'm Andrea Ventress, Deputy Editor of Wedding Magazine, and if your conundrum over cakes is nigh on catastrophic, then keep watching. Coming up on today's show, modern or traditional, the choices are endless when it comes to your cake, but what will this bride decide? And then we'll be meeting a lady who wants a chocolate cake, but what about all the oldies who say only fruit will do? I'm joined by bride-to-be Amanda Ormsby. Hello, Amanda.
Hiya.
Hi, welcome to The Wedding Experts. So tell me a little bit about your big day. Have you set the date?
We're still deciding on dates at the moment, all to be confirmed in the next, I'd say, week or so. Although we do have the slight problem of cake, in that I can't stand fruitcake or marzipan, and okay. The other half absolutely loves both.
Okay, so that's quite a traditional kind of cake. Do you have any ideas whether you want to go traditional or modern?
I'd prefer not to go traditional. I want to, something a little bit different, I think. But the other half wants to go down that road, so we're a bit stuck in the middle.
Okay, yeah. Well, we've got a really good expert lined up for you today.
Excellent.
Award-winning cake designer Peggy Porschen, who's designed wedding cakes for the likes of Stella McCartney. So let's have a look at what she has to say.
Great. I'm Peggy Porschen, and my business is called Peggy Porschen Cakes. We create highly bespoke wedding cakes and cakes for special occasions, and we've been going since 2003. I started as a small home cake baker and built up a reputation for beautiful wedding cakes. When it comes to wedding cakes, there are quite a lot of choices you can have. We produce tiered wedding cakes, classic contemporary, miniature cakes and cupcakes. We are very well known for our beautiful floral decorations and romantic intricate detail. The first consideration when you choose a wedding cake, I recommend, first of all, it's all about you and really think about what you would like. Secondly, the venue, the flowers, your reception style, the number of guests, all these are important things to consider when you choose your cake. For example, if you're getting married in a traditional venue with a large ballroom, you need quite a statement centerpiece because you can't have something small that would get lost. If you have a funky wedding party, you could go for cupcakes. For example, if you're just serving cocktails and canapés, they are really lovely to eat, they're bite-sized, they're not too scary to bite into, so that's a really nice choice. If you're having cupcakes for your wedding cake, which is not so traditional, but you still like to have a cutting cake, we recommend to have a top tier, which is just a small 6-inch cake decorated in a similar style to your cupcakes, and you can use it for the cutting ceremony. The brides that come to us for their wedding cake are usually looking for a very highly skilled craftsmanship, for something very pretty, floral and intricate. I think we built ourselves a reputation for beautiful sugar flowers, beautiful pipe detail and wonderful colours as well. Brides often come to us because they want to have a bespoke cake created for them. They may just twist a design that we have already in our portfolio to suit their style, but very often I'm sitting there on a sketchbook and designing a completely new cake from scratch. Wedding cakes in the past few years have evolved from something quite traditional, a little bit boring and old-fashioned, to something really beautiful, almost pieces of art, I should say. A lot of detail goes into wedding cakes these days. A lot of brides choose sugar flowers as opposed to fresh flowers because they actually value the skill and craft that goes into a wedding cake. A wedding cake nowadays can become as elaborate as you like, really. I mean, there are limits in terms of how edible it will be at the end. Personally, I prefer to have as much edible decoration on a cake as possible. But for example, only a couple of weeks ago, did a 5-foot wedding cake, one of the biggest ones we've ever done. And it was decorated with hand-painted embroidery and lace, pearls and sparks, and actually instead of using plaster pillars, it was separated with crystal candlesticks and crystals. If you're having a country wedding in a barn, for example, to most people the obvious choice would be cupcakes. However, I always say that although I love cupcakes, it is something that you could also have for birthday parties, for example. So if you'd like something a little bit more traditional but still in the look of the country theme, you could have iced miniature cakes. They're just as cute, but just a little bit more sophisticated and smooth, perfectly iced as well. You could decorate them with polka dots and stripes to be a little bit funky, or also have a couple of sugar blossoms to look like country flowers sprinkled over the top. Something like this here, for example, is one of our designs, a cute dot and bow design, or Lily of the Valleys, which are also really, really popular for country style weddings. There are so many possibilities these days. If you want to go over the top with a cake, you can.
Wow, 5-foot wedding cake. Amanda, is that the kind of thing that you'd like?
I'll pass.
A little bit too much, maybe.
Indeed.
I'd like to introduce you to our amazing expert. This Hello. Is Victoria Sullivan. She's the style editor of Wedding Magazine and Wedding Flowers Magazine. Now, Victoria, you put together all our lovely reception pages. You must see a lot of different styles of wedding cakes. What would you say would be the big trend at the moment?
Well, that's right, Andrea. We do see loads of wedding cakes, particularly fairy cakes or cupcakes seem to be a very big trend at the moment. I don't know whether you've noticed all the shops that are now opening that sell cupcakes, such as the Hummingbird Bakery and lots of other different ones. But basically, that's a massive trend. I think people really like the idea of each guest being able to have their own cake.
So are people veering away more from the traditional tiered fruit cake?
I think that a lot of brides still do go for a traditional style of cake, because just as they go for a traditional dress, they still like to go for a traditional cake. But I think there's just so much more choice now. I mean, you can have a croquembouche, which I don't know whether, Amanda, you know, that which is almost like a whole big tower of profiteroles, which is really lovely. Or you can have donuts, which are all stacked on top of each other. There's so much choice. It's really up to what you want and what's going to look right on your day.
So if you go for this kind of different style, I guess there is the problem, as Peggy said, about the whole cutting the cake tradition. So what would you recommend in this kind of scenario?
Well, if you don't want to lose that age-old tradition, which is very important, especially for your photographs, I would probably go for a small top tier and then have that as the cutting ceremony. Otherwise, if you have cupcakes, it's really quite cute if you and your husband then take a cupcake and both eat them at the same time and then have your photo taken doing that, which is a really sweet idea as well.
That's a lovely idea. I've also heard about brides in this current climate, obviously budget is key, of serving the wedding cake as a dessert. Is this something that you're seeing more often?
Yeah, absolutely. I think, you know, times are tough and you need to cut back on certain things, and that's another way of doing so. And I think the most important thing is that you're saving on cost, but also it means that everyone actually eats your cake. A lot of the time you find that when guests have been served dessert and then they're served a wedding cake as well, it just means that they're so full up they can't eat it. So I think if you want your guests to enjoy your cake, that is a really good idea.
And you could save a good sort of £500 to £600 doing that.
Absolutely.
So in this case, though, timing-wise, traditionally you cut the cake after the speeches, is that right?
You cut the cake, yes.
So in this case, would you need to do it before you even sit down for the wedding breakfast?
There's no hard or fast rule about when you actually can do this. Some people say you can cut it actually before guests sit down for dinner. Otherwise, it can be cut after the plates have been cleared after dinner. So after your main meal, then the cake can be cut, and then when the speeches are being made, the cake can be plated up so that it's ready to be served after the speeches have finished.
And can the caterers do anything to sort of zhuzh it up a bit so it's just not a slab of cake on a plate?
Well, there's lots of different things. They can add some coulis, or they can add berries, fresh fruit, or if it's a summer wedding, maybe some ice cream or sorbet on the side always can glam it up a bit.
That sounds lovely. Amanda, sort of all of these different ideas, have you got any inspiration?
Yeah, no, I've got too many ideas. I came in here with the question mark at the top, and I've got a few ideas now actually to take back to the other half to go through. But I think ultimately it'll be my decision, so I think I'll go with a couple of things you have actually mentioned today.
I think you could go for traditional, Vicky, but you could also do something quite modern with the design of the cake.
Yeah, absolutely.
What are you seeing at the moment? Is that the big trend in that?
Well, you can still have a tiered cake, but actually have some colour. There's no reason why you have to have a white cake or a cream cake. You can actually add flour by adding some really lovely fresh flowers. I mean, that's it's an excellent way of how to bring some life to a traditional tiered cake, but yeah, also brightening up so it doesn't look so traditional and so it can be more contemporary.
Yeah. I've actually heard about brides putting sort of fruits and tiny little pineapples, some berries on the top. Is that a nice idea?
Yeah, absolutely. We're going to be doing a feature in the next issue of Wedding, actually, which is about buying a cake yourself and then decorating it. And lots of ideas such as buying flowers, adding sweets, putting chocolates around the rim, or buying cupcakes, because now M&S are even selling cupcakes, so you could even buy them from them and actually dress them up on a tiered cake stand yourself. So there's so many ideas and options out there for you.
That's another great way to save cost as well, doing
absolutely
it yourself. Do you think that might add pressure on the bride though, or sort of a few days before doing her wedding cake?
I think the bride can give it to someone else to do.
Call it mother-in-law. Maybe,
exactly. Bridesmaids, anyone. I think it's also a job that someone would enjoy doing. I don't think they'd see it as a real task. I'd see it as them being creative for your day. And of course you'll be directing them to make sure that they get it right.
It's a nice way to add personal touches, actually, to get someone from your wedding party to be very involved in it. So if your mother-in-law is a whiz at doing fruitcakes and decorating, that's a really nice idea. Yeah. Do you think she might be up for that?
Yes, actually, she is a whiz at cakes.
Really?
Yes, oh yes, definitely. So that might be an option, definitely.
Well, lovely, some great ideas there from Vicky. Thank you very much. Amanda, I hope we've given you some food for thought. Still to come on The Wedding Experts, we've got yet another bride-to-be going nuts over her cake. Join us after the break. Joining me in the studio is bride-to-be Katie Messer. Hello, Katie.
Hi.
Now, I hear it's a very romantic story about your proposal and how you met. Fill us in.
We met on a blind date at the end of May. We moved in together 3 weeks later. We were engaged in December and we're getting married in October.
That's fantastic. When you know, you know.
Exactly.
So how far have you got down the planning route? Have you obviously set the date? Have you got anything else in
mind?
Oh
yeah, we've set the date. We've booked our venue. I have my dress. I have my flowers.
Wow.
And the only thing we can't agree on is cakes.
Okay, so tell us your dilemma. What's the problem?
I want chocolate cake because I want to eat it and I want everyone to enjoy it. Mm-hmm. And he wants fruitcake because he is convinced that it's the more traditional route.
Okay, is he having any influence from his family maybe, or is that just
his
idea?
No, there's been no problems there, but he's just trying to give his input so that he has some part of the wedding planning.
Fair enough. Okay, well, we've got a really, really excellent expert lined up for you today. It's Mich Turner. She's the founder of the Little Venice Cake Company, and she's designed delicious delights for the likes of Madonna, Pierce Brosnan, and even David Beckham. So let's have a look at what she has to say.
My name is Mich Turner, and I'm the founder and director of London's Little Venice Cake Company. We look after a number of high-profile clients for their wedding and special occasion cakes. I've been fortunate enough to create wedding cakes for Madonna, Pierce Brosnan, Paul McCartney, Cheryl Cole, and Sophie Ellis-Bextor, Kate Garraway. Our strengths lie very much in our iconic design, combining that with delicious cakes, creating designs of breathtaking beauty with intricate craftsmanship that are completely bespoke. We have probably in the region of 15 clients that would come and see us on a weekly basis at the studio. They would meet with one of our designers to peruse the cakes that we have on display, have a look through the portfolios, taste all the flavours that we have in our repertoire, and discuss their personal preferences and design ideas with one of our designers. A Little Venice Cake Company cake is something to be admired and beautified. I'm very proud of our creations, and we work very hard to ensure that our designs are iconic. They tend to be clean, classical, and flawless, very much inspired by fashion, beautiful details, so that they don't look messed around. They look very clean and very chic. That combined with the most delicious flavoured cakes, where we work with really good quality ingredients, I think goes to sum up a really fantastic Little Venice Cake Company cake. The there are a number of different flavours that you can use inside your wedding cake, and this is why our consultations can take some time, because people get to enjoy and sample all the different mouth-watering ideas. Traditional rich fruit cake is the most popular. It's nice to include it as an element somewhere within the wedding, whether you keep it as the top tier for a future christening or first wedding anniversary can be a nice idea, or it can go as the base of a wedding cake where it supports the weight of the other tiers. But I think what's important to remember is that not everybody likes fruitcake, and it can be quite nice to have a compromise by offering different flavours within the different tiers that can still be decorated in exactly the same way. But what that means is that you can have a tier of fruitcake, there may be a tier of chocolate cake, topped with a carrot cake, a luscious lemon cake, a vanilla cake, and suddenly you've got a 5-tier wedding cake. I think it's really lovely that these days you can have so many different flavours within your wedding cake, and that doesn't usually have a cost implication. The number of tiers and the size of tiers and the amount of decoration will affect the cost of your wedding cake. But certainly if you want to have a tier of fruit and a tier of chocolate, you shouldn't be penalised for having good taste. I think when it comes to choosing wedding cakes, the biggest dilemma for a bride, certainly that we've found, is which flavours to have and how can they get all of their chosen flavours within the style of cake that they want. There are a lot of important elements when it comes to choosing the cake for a bride. And we actually put together a how to design and choose your wedding cake to give brides some help before they come for their consultation. But I think certainly one of the most important things is to ensure that you have a cake large enough to serve the number of guests that you have coming to your wedding. Secondly, that the flavours work well with what you may be having before you come to eat the cake. Certainly, if you're thinking of serving the cake for pudding, you should think about having something that's palatable for pudding, like a chocolate cake or a lemon or a vanilla cake. If you're having a cake that's going to be served in addition to, does it stand up well to a champagne toast? A nice rich fruit cake will stand up well with champagne or a nice coffee. So I think it's important to certainly think about the size of cake, the flavour of cake, and then really the decoration should be a reflection of your personality, carrying the whole ethos and theme of your wedding through to the finale, the pièce de résistance of when you come to cut your cake.
Lots of amazing ideas. Mich, welcome to the Wedding Expert.
It's my pleasure to be here. Thank you for having me.
And so, Katie, you're having this massive dilemma about whether to go for chocolate or traditional fruitcake. Now, I think actually Mich answered your question there perfectly about having different tiers.
Mm, exactly. Well, firstly, congratulations, Katie. Thank you. Your special day, and you should be quite right to have exactly what you want. And I think certainly something that, you know, your dilemma is not restricted to you. It's something that I see all the time. And it's actually very rare that we would create a cake that would have all tiers fruitcake or all tiers chocolate cake. You know, normally these days we would have a wedding cake which would have different tiers of different flavours. And this can be a fantastic way of having that all-important compromise to start the wedding.
So which flavours sort of last better? Because I guess you have to make the cake a few days before the wedding, is that right?
Yeah, you're absolutely right. Most cakes would be baked fresh the week of the wedding if you're working with a more fresh cake, like a chocolate, a lemon, a vanilla, a carrot. The traditional rich fruit celebration cakes do need probably about 8 weeks maturing time in order that they're really good on the day. Otherwise, they tend to crumble and tend to sort of taste a little bit buttery, whereas once they've matured, the real flavours of the vine fruits come through. Mm. So, it's important that the cake is baked fresh early part of the week so that it can be decorated in time to be ready on the wedding day.
And do you find some brides actually do, you know, a fruit cake, chocolate cake, lemon cake, carrot cake, that all full tiers?
All the time. Not usually four different flavours, because what can happen if you're having a wedding for, say, maybe up to sort of 80 or 100 people and you're working with a 3-tier cake, if you have three different flavours, it means that the flavour that's on the very top, you've maybe only got 15 to 20 portions. And if that becomes the most popular one on the day, you can suddenly find yourself restricted. So we normally suggest sort of two flavours within the construction of a cake.
So it would actually work perfectly well.
Perfectly,
cake,
chocolate for Katie. And perfectly. And fruit cake. Yes.
How many guests are you having to the big day?
To sit down and eat, we have 100, and then we've probably got at least another 50 coming for the evening.
Okay. And are you planning to serve the cake as dessert?
No, I was thinking of either having it as a favour,
nice
or
idea.
Just letting people plough through it as the evening goes on.
So it kind of needs to be able to feed about 150 people. What kind of size cake are we looking
for? Great, well, it gives a number of different options, the way that you're intending to serve your cake. Because you're not serving it for pudding, it instantly opens up some sort of various other options. If you were serving the cake for pudding, I would suggest that we would make the cake majority in chocolate, with maybe just the top tier as the fruitcake, because chocolate lends itself to being served for pudding, whereas the fruitcake is very much an in addition to. And in that instance, I would have suggested maybe the top tier as the fruitcake, which would give your husband the opportunity to have his little bit of fruitcake, or to keep it certainly for a potential future christening, as is the tradition. But because you're intending to serve the cake in addition to later on once your evening guests have come, various ideas here. Certainly it can be a stacked tiered cake, which will look amazing for those additional evening guests, which gives you another cutting opportunity and is a fantastic way of incorporating those evening guests to feel part of the ceremony, because you can have a champagne toast, cut the cake and then serve it. And it's a good way of stretching the buffet at that time of the evening. The alternative way is if you're talking about giving them as favours, what this gives you the option of having is, as we've seen already, some smaller individual cakes where you can certainly have half of them made in chocolate, which can be covered in white chocolate or dark chocolate and decorated. And you can have the other half made in fruitcake, covered either with marzipan and icing, or icing that's actually coloured to look like white chocolate. So essentially you could have the whole cake celebration looking very cohesive.
Fantastic. And you've mentioned about keeping a tier for the christening. Do brides still do this?
It's something that I like to encourage as a mum myself, and it's something that I did. I kept the top tier of my wedding cake as a rich fruit cake, which I popped in the freezer, and it kept very, very happily there for sort of 6 years before I brought it out for the christening. Yeah, and it is a tradition which I say to clients, you know, if you don't do it, you can never do it. And whilst, you know, the last thing on your mind at the time of the wedding may be going on to have children, it's such a lovely, nostalgic, emotional thing to be able to do when it comes to the christening day. If you've kept your top tier, you can take it out of the freezer, literally have their name piped on the cake with some flowers similar to maybe what you had on the wedding day. And you can serve it at the christening in addition to, you know, a lovely big chocolate cake. But if you are going to keep the top tier, it should really be the fruit cake, because that has the best keeping qualities.
Would you need to remove the icing and the marzipan?
You can do. I didn't personally, because I really wanted it exactly as it was on my wedding day. But it's certainly something that if it has become discoloured, then yes, you strip it. And especially if you've had your wedding cake pink and you've maybe had a little boy, strip the cake and then have it re-iced so that it's fresh on the day.
Well, I can't contain myself anymore. I can see you've bought
some samples.
Some cakes.
I have. Now, most people say when they come to us, they say, oh, I don't like fruitcake. And it's because they haven't tried ours. So I'm looking forward to you trying some. This is the traditional rich fruitcake. It's actually baked to a Victorian recipe. It's got a nice high fruit content with lots of brandy. And then there's the chocolate truffle torte that's made with the melted chocolate with the chocolate ganache buttercream. So do try a little bit and tell me what you think.
It's amazing.
Have we convinced you? See?
Mm. That's lovely.
Conversion.
Obviously, we know how gorgeous chocolate cake is. Would you like to have a bit of that?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Let's try some chocolate cake.
Thank you.
Before I tuck in any more to this delicious fruitcake, it just remains for me to say thank you very much, Mich. Thank you very much, Katie. And join us next time when we'll be talking flowers. See you then.